Yo, and welcome back everyone to another great video. We're going to be doing a very, very epic video today. We're going to be going over how to create a mini BR map in a thermometer island using custom terrain. Boy, was that a mouthful. By the end of this video, you're going to have a complete working mini BR map to show your friends. Now, if you're not comfortable with cut, copy, and some other features in the toolbar, I highly suggest watching the video Fortnite Creative for Beginners first. I will go ahead and link that at the top right and also in the description below. I will be using a lot of these features and I want you to know how to use them. Now, before we start building, we do need to choose a starter island first. What we're gonna choose for our island is an XL island at the very bottom. These XL islands do not use the traditional memory system that we have seen in the past. They use something called the thermometer. So we're gonna get into that a little bit later, but for right now, we're gonna choose an XL island that works best for us. The XL Archipelago Island, I think. We're gonna choose that because it is the flattest out of all of them, and it gives us the most custom terrain options for us to build on. Let's go ahead and now rename the island to something that we want to name our island. In this case, I'm going to name mine Directing Pete's Mini BR. Once you've chosen a name for your island, you can always change it later. You are all set, and we are one step closer to building a Battle Royale map. If your island looks like this, you have loaded the correct island and we are ready to start building our thermometer mini BR. Go ahead now and mark the center of the map. So right when you open the map, the cursor will be dead center. Just mark that so we can see it. You want to start building in the middle of the map and start to build out in kind of a cylinder direction and make coverage that way. That way you're starting from the dead center and moving out. Now moving on to terrain, we're gonna go ahead and go into our galleries and select terrain. Now for this, we're gonna go ahead and use the Gray Cliff Grass Gallery. We're gonna go into that gallery and now, unlike my old videos, we're gonna be using this piece right here. It's like a square flat pancake piece. This is how we're gonna build our terrain. So we're gonna grab that piece right there and we're gonna make it as big as possible. Before we go ahead and place our terrain, it is very important that we go over the options on the left-hand side because these need to be set properly before we start building. All right, let's go over a few things in the quick menu here. We want to make sure drops are off. Collision needs to be put on nothing. You don't want it to collide with anything because we want those copies to kind of overlap. So collide with copies is on. We do want our grid snap to be at 8. I'll explain in a minute why 8 is better. Building is prop. This is the most important thing. You need to get this right, or you are gonna create some very destructive terrain. So here's what you need to do. Origin center. Building is prop, origin center. Whenever you're building terrain, make sure that it is set to origin center. If you have it to off when you're building this, I promise you that later on when people are breaking the floors in your map, they will be able to break the terrain as well and get under your map, and it just makes a very buggy and not fun experience. So now we have our terrain piece. We set all the settings correct. Now what we want to do is place our first build. It looks like it might be perfect, but you may want to build a ramp or something. Now, when I build that ramp, I'm noticing I actually built it too high up. I don't see the bottom of the ramp. So you want to build it low enough where you see the bottom of the ramp for two reasons. One, when people build, you'll be able to see their builds. And two, if you're trying to build houses and stuff, you need it to be level. All right, we're going to click our piece here and we're going to start building. So literally you're just clicking around. Now see the white line there? If you see that mesh line, now if I pick it up a little too high there, you notice it disappears, it goes too low. But when it's even, you'll see that white blend line. That's showing that's exactly even, and that's what we want. So when you're seeing that white blending line, that's perfect. Already, guys, we've created some terrain. Does it look beautiful? Not at all, but we're getting there. So we're going to just keep doing this. I want to go ahead and start turning my terrain a little bit. So we're going to go to a rotation axis and we're going to start rotating our terrain a little bit because we don't want it to just look like this square, right? We want to start giving it some personality. So every time I walk now, as you can see, I'm rotating my terrain. What I'm actually creating right now, guys, I'm creating a pond on my terrain using the actual water in the map instead of using one of the water galleries. So what's beautiful about this, look at that. We've already created a little lake on our map. Now we do want to fill in and rotate and fill in these edges because they look a little rough. And moving on, now we're going to go ahead and show you how to build a ramp with the terrain. We're going to build an actual hill with terrain. We're going to go ahead and put a little angle on it right there. We're going to go ahead and place that one there. And what I'm trying to do is blend in another ramp right there, and then we're going to do one more. But see how I'm trying to make it so the line is a long straight line there? That's kind of what you want, because then it creates this nice flush hill. So now we're going to place a piece right on top of our hill here, because we're going to level off our hill and create some more room to build. But guys, it's not that easy. So you can't just place a build on top, because look what's happening. If I put a build right here, it's building under the map. That's not good. We actually have to build up a little bit higher. So what we're going to do first, we're going to take this piece and we're going to go ahead and measure it out and make sure it's right under that ramp, and we're going to place it. Perfect. Now, when we're all done with that, we're going to grab another piece and we're going to shrink it a little bit here. Okay, we're going to shrink the depth. We're going to get it so we can fill that gap. So we're gonna drop it in. It looks a little low. So, you know, we can go ahead and click on it again. But yeah, once you've cut and pasted a couple times, you'll get it right. Now you can build more houses, more POIs, and you can continue your journey creating amazing landscape around your map. And to just quickly finish off here, we're just grabbing some of these gap pieces here and we're just merging them in. They don't have to be extremely perfect. You want to know why? Because terrain is not extremely perfect. Let's move on. So what we're going to do now, we're going to go ahead and grab some of these edge pieces. Okay, so back in that same gray cliff gallery, grab one of these corner pieces. And then what I want you to do is bring it to max size. So just size it up and make it as big as possible. Once it is fully sized and as big as possible, put it on grid snap 2, place them next to each other like this, then select both pieces and go ahead and cut them. We're gonna now go to grid snap off. So we're gonna angle it right here and not make it so dead center, because as you know, mountain ridges have like a little slope to them. So let's go ahead and just go to the ridge line. What's great is it doesn't need to be perfect. So you can just keep going around here and you can make finishing touches later, but just get an outline going and start building. What's also great is if you expand your map later, you can always just break that part of the ridge and start expanding your map and building around it. And then on these last kind of pieces here, just angle it a little differently, right? We're just doing a little angle because it's getting smaller at the end. We're kind of carving down in the mountain, going into more of a flat area. What you may actually need to do is grab one of these pieces, and then when you try to get it down there, you'll notice it's too tall. So it starts to turn red. You're gonna have to resize the height. So you wanna bring that height down just a little bit. Then once you're done with the height, you can create that roll again and start placing them again. This may take a couple times to get it right. You just wanna get something that closes off that gap so people can't get under your map. So before we go any further, I want to talk about one very important thing. Go to My Island and Tools. You're going to see something called Create Island Backup. People do not do this enough, and I promise you, you're going to save yourself a lot of hurt just by backing up daily. So every day you put some time into your map, make sure you hit that backup button. And as you do, when you come back in, you will notice there is a backup date and time. Please do this so you avoid losing all of your hard work. Let's take a break for a minute and move on to player spawn pads. So we're gonna go ahead and grab a player spawn pad, open up the options, and only change one option here, which is visible during games. We're gonna turn that to no. Next, we'll go ahead and place these around the map. And I'm gonna do this in more of a circular motion, just because I think it'd be cool to see everybody load in and look at each other while they're loading in. For this example, I kinda like the idea of everyone loading in around a lake. So what I have learned to save memory, you do not need all of your player spawns. So you don't need all 16 for people to load in. You can have anywhere between 8 and 16, maybe save some memory. It does not matter. Let's go ahead and check our settings one last time. Drops off, collision, nothing. Grid snap, 8, and then origin center for building is prop. Okay, perfect, we're ready to go. So now we're gonna do a different building style. We did the ramp style before, and now what we're gonna do is a gradient style where the mountain goes up slowly. So what we're doing here, see how I'm now creating a level here? You'll see I go up one little notch there, and it's just creating this beautiful layering up of a mountain. It feels like we're just moving up gradually. This is just another building style with this terrain piece. You may also wanna do two clicks up like I'm doing right here. Now you're noticing I can't really stop building because my leveling is incorrect. If I were to place a build, it'd be under the map. So we need to do another build up here. So you want to keep doing that until you get to a point where you can place your build. So you can see here, I can place my building materials, and that is exactly what we want. So I want to kind of recreate that double piece again, but I want to do it just a little bit smaller. So once again, grab a corner piece, make it as big as possible. But now the only difference is we're going to go ahead and change the height. Bring the height down to about half. Once you've done that, go ahead and commit your change and then rotate it and commit again. Perfect. Now we have these two smaller building pieces. We're going to cut that. We're going to go back to grid snap off. And now we're going to go ahead and just level it, give it a little bit of an angle again and place it. So you know how to do this, guys. Just go around the map and finish it off. Okay, so we're going to go into devices, and now we're going to go ahead and grab an advanced storm controller. So go ahead and select that. Now, I like to put mine up and away. I usually use a grid snap for, and the reason for that is because we're going to be doing some stacking up in the sky. All right, storm phases, set that to custom. Then we're going to leave the phase one radius to 200. All right, we'll leave it there. And then you may also want to change the delay time to about 1 minute. Now go back to devices, grab an advanced storm beacon. All right, these beacons are gonna communicate with the advanced storm controller because we chose custom, remember? So now on that advanced storm beacon, we're gonna leave the first one on phase one. We're gonna do the end radius. The end radius on the default storm was already 200. So we're gonna leave the end radius at 100 for this because we don't want it to be the same. The wait time, 1 minute. Or 2 minutes, depending on what you want to do here. This is up to you guys. You can change the flow as you test out your map. Resize time, 1 minute. Damage, yeah, 1% because it's the really early storm. This is super important, guys. Movement behavior. You want to set this to move randomly. If you set it to move beacon, it's going to be extremely boring because the storm is just gonna go to the beacon every time. People are gonna know what your storm circles are like. So you wanna make sure you move it to move randomly. This creates some randomness to the storm and makes it feel unique every time. Move distance minimum and maximum. That's how random the storm is gonna be. Right now, I'm gonna do 75 to 100 because I want it to be somewhat controlled, but I do want it to be somewhat randomized. The farther those numbers are apart from each other, the more random it will become. However, that could be extremely chaotic. Next one, phase two, we're gonna bring everything down a tick. End radius, wait time, resize time, damage we're gonna bring up from 1% to 2%, move distance 75, we're gonna bring that to 50, we're gonna bring the other one to 75. So guys, what we've done is just brought everything down a tick. We're gonna do it again for phase three. So this is pretty simple. We're gonna go click down one, we're clicking down one. I will leave that, we'll bring that up to 5 actually. We're gonna go ahead and do move distance to 40 and leave that at 50. And now on this one, we'll do it a little bit differently. So we're gonna go ahead and move this down maybe to, we can leave it at 40 at this point. Yeah, we'll click down one more time actually. The resize time I left at 20 that time. You know, you're gonna have to fill this out. Everyone's map is different. If you're copying me exactly, it may not work on your map. Because your map may be a different size than mine. As the map grows, you're gonna have to expand these numbers out as well. But just go ahead and use these numbers. You can mimic what I'm putting in here for right now. All I'm doing is shrinking down to 0. The idea is you wanna get to 0 because that's when the storm completely closes and ends and the game completely finishes. So we wanna go ahead and finish that off. And guys, just like that, we have created an advanced storm controller. So before we go any further, go to My Island, then UI, go to Map Screen Display, change that from Scoreboard to Overview Map. For a Battle Royale, we want to see an overview map, and for testing, this is very important. So now you're going to load into your game. We will come out of the sky at some point once we've done the settings, but you'll see right there, there's our storm, and there's where next circle will be. Now, I don't like that there's no delay, so I'm going to add a quick delay to the storm before we wrap up. So in the advanced storm controller, that bottom controller, just set the delay to 1 minute. Now you'll notice when I start the game, the difference now is you won't see a storm circle when we first start for up to 1 minute. You don't want people to have stress when they first land in your map that there's a storm already. Let them loot up, get comfortable. All right, so now we're gonna start building. We're gonna go to galleries. For this, I'm gonna be using the Weeping Woods gallery along with some other galleries, Pleasant Park, some other ones as well, but mainly I'm gonna be using Weeping Woods. Unlike last time, building as prop should be turned off. And the reason for that is, you know how like when you break the first level of a building, the rest of the floors on top top will come crashing down. Well, if you have build the prop on, you won't be able to do that. Also, you will not be able to build properly within your building. So now when you're building, you want to make sure you actually have build the prop off rather than origin centered, like when we're building terrain. So make sure it's the opposite. So as you're seeing here, I'm just building a outline of a structure, and I'm going to speed through this part. What I'm actually going to do is provide a code. The map code will be provided below, so make sure to check out that map code. I'm going to speed build through this and show you the finished result. And then what I want you to do is just try to build your own version of this. All right, friends, and here's the finished product. So basically, I want you to spend some time making a really nice small build on your POI with the tools I showed you. Remember, because we built with GridSnap 8, we measured our building, we were able to build on the surface perfectly. So go through, see what I've done here, see what props I've used. This is just to inspire you and give you a feel of what you can do. If you feel like you're still having a hard time building, go to the Weeping Woods Cabin in Prefabs. What I want you to do is put that in your quick bar, and then I want you to place it somewhere in the sky near the map. Now, the reason I want you to do this, you can get inspired by just going through, maybe even grabbing pieces from a pre-built like this, and grab elements, then incorporate it into your map. So go ahead and use prefabs as a way to be creative if you're having trouble. And then when you're done, just go ahead and delete it all. All right, so we are gonna have to go ahead and go to devices next, grab the map indicator device, because guys, we're gonna name our first POI. We're gonna go ahead and place this down. We're gonna remove the icon A to none. And then what we're gonna do is basically just change the text, and that's it. We're gonna name this my old POI name, Lucid Lake House, just for this example. And so go ahead and name this whatever you want on your map. We're all done. You'll go ahead and look at the map, and look at that, guys. We have our first POI, Lucid Lake House. Isn't that awesome? So we're already getting started here. And now if you wanted to like do another POI, now this is too soon to do another POI, but I just wanna show you how simple it is. You just click this, grab it, drag it over, and then all you have to do is place it, and then you just rename it. And that's it. So I wanna go over nature a little bit. We're gonna go into the Variant Foliage Gallery. That's a really great gallery. And also the Variant Foliage Gallery B. So A and B are great. You have the pine trees and then we have the normal trees. Since this looks like a wood cabin, I'm gonna have a pine tree theme near the cabin. I wanna talk about nature for a moment. We want to save memory. We don't wanna go crazy on memory, but we also want our maps to look really good. So here is some advice for you. I would rather you spend a lot of your memory on good nature, because most of our maps are gonna be nature. We do have POIs, and those POIs are gonna be cool. We could reuse a lot of props on those POIs, but where I think we can get a little bit crazy with memory is nature. And the reason is, that is what makes a map look good. I am gonna encourage you to use different types of trees, different types of bushes, just to create this beautiful feel. Now, maybe in a separate section of our map, we will go ahead and use a different type of tree here. Now, here's a building trick I wanna teach you guys. When you're placing trees and pine trees, make sure you set drops to on or off. You can use them on for pine trees and off for this kind of tree. Then go to GridSnap off and then resize all. And see what I'm doing here? I'm spinning around. So as I'm spinning, that's actually rotating the tree. This is also very important when you're building nature. Resize your trees, spin around. As long as grid snap is off, you should be good to go here with resizing. Basically, I'm going through all the nature gallery. Right now I'm building around the lake. You can do the same. Take cues from this. Go to the code in the description below of this finished map. I'm using some stuff from the jungle gallery, and that's okay. You can use jungle elements in a forest and vice versa. Your forest will still look like a forest, I promise, if you use some of the jungle pieces and some of the swamp pieces, it still will look like a forest. All right, and finally, we're adding some rocks to the map, different types of rocks. Use rocks that you know that you can use other places on your map as well. Rocks are another one you're gonna use. Now open a hole in your map up in that one empty area. We're gonna throw in another terrain style here. So this is in the upper area where there is nothing. I put a hole in the map and I'm just placing this down. Remember to use origin center. Then we're gonna grab one of the liquid pieces from the liquid gallery and we're gonna expand it out width and depth, not height. And once you're done with that, you're gonna go ahead and place it and we're gonna create a man-made lake. So now we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna grab some of the nature materials from the other lake and we're gonna decorate this one as well. So we have a beautiful map, but we need chests and ammo. So go to Devices, Chest and Ammo Gallery. Once you go ahead and choose that, make sure drops are off so you don't lose them when you place them. Guys, these chests take up a ton of memory. That one does, and so does this one. So I'm not gonna be using them on my BR because they just take up so much unnecessary memory. We're gonna go ahead and drop the chest down around the map. Don't think about making chests so hard to find on your map because the loot coming out of these chests aren't very good anyway. At least currently during the recording of this video. So we want to just drop the chests as many as possible to make people feel like they have options, they can keep opening chests. Same with ammo boxes, guys. Drop ammo boxes in weird places like the attic. Drop chests in the attic because a lot of people will land on the top of a building and break the roof in. Let's quickly chat about Thermometer Islands as a whole. We built this beautiful Lucidite lake house. You're noticing some green is starting to develop. So blue means you didn't build in that area at all. Green means you're starting to build. Yellow means it's getting a little bit more memory. Orange, red, and then there's these exclamation marks that warn you they're getting very close to the end, and then some locks. Now, unfortunately, when you see a lock on the map, you won't be able to build not just in the locked area, but in the entire surrounding area, which is a little misleading and hard to understand. However, this is what I suggest. Build in the middle. See that island area? Don't build outside of the island. So try not to build your BRs past the island area because otherwise I think they just get too big. Directing Pete's Battle Royale actually stays within this little circle circumference right here. Then use this outside area here is more like scenery. Just put mountainscapes and other things. Actually in Directing Pete's Battle Royale Season 5, I built mountains around this island here so it just didn't look like a template island. All right, get ready to hit that pause button, guys, because you're gonna be going through this one by one, copying these settings. So go ahead and just pause this video, do the settings, resume the video. So basically, this is coming right out of Directing Pete's Battle Royale Season 5. Please note, I use gold based on elimination. So this set of settings will reward somebody 5 gold when they eliminate someone. Then they can cash those out in a vending machine. If you want a tutorial on vending machines giving out gold, please let me know in the comments below. But otherwise, this is all of the settings that you need in order to make your BR work properly. Go ahead and copy these. And if you want to see a more in-depth tutorial on this, click on the link on the top right or in the description below. I will lead you to the best settings for a BR map where I actually describe how to do this one by one and really get into details. Alright guys, that pretty much wraps it up. We made a BR map from scratch, and I showed you all of the best settings to use to make the ultimate BR. I really hope this tutorial helped. Please let me know in the comments below if you want me to do any other videos. Also, remember, I listed a bunch of other videos below that will help you make your maps even better, like custom loot pools, better storm ideas, better understanding of settings, etc. So make sure you check out those links below. If you like the content you see, please like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much, and until next time, take care.